Morning, YouTube. We got all these offcuts, and we got some shorter pallet boards that I can't use for the long dresser. We got some glued together tops left over from the toolbox tabletop, and we're going to turn these into a nightstand for my daughter. See a picture of it here that we're going to be using to go along with this. It should be 17 by 20 by about 30 inches tall. So let's get to it. I got billing to do, and I'll tell you what's going on as I'm cutting this wood up. All right, to the joiner.
So we start this video at the joiner, just like every other video. I think I'm gonna have to start my videos a little different. But I gotta check for extra nails, screws, staples. You should always double check when you're using pallet wood, because if you think you got all your nails out, you're probably about 50% right. Next up, you guessed it, is the planer. We're gonna bring all these boards in around 3/4 of an inch. Because, well, 3/4 of an inch is just good. And then we'll move to the table saw. Now, these boards are just over 3 inches. I wanted to go with 2-inch rail styles, but being 3 inches, I could get 1.5 inches, and that worked pretty good. You'll see. Stick around, check it out. But you can see the broken board there. It's a good thing I didn't need all that. I was able to cut most of that out and still have a pretty good piece of wood left. A lot of these boards are broken on the ends. That's why I wanted to use them on this project. I could get 2.5-inch boards out of one of these broken boards. Now we're off to the router table, where I run it through the rail and style bits to give me a nice OG profile, and then we will take it and cut it to length over on the miter saw. So I set up a stop block for the rails, and then I set up another stop block for the styles. That way, everything is all the same all the way around, so everything should be nice and square when I go to put it together. I'm using a jig I made to run these rails through. That way it keeps them nice and square to the fence. I'm also using a stop block for all of my panels. That way they're all the same height, and two of them need to be the same width. So the back one will be a little bit bigger, only by a couple of inches though. But I used a stop block for that one.
So in my last video, y'all seen where I made these panels? Well, where I cut the edges of the panels anyway. I used a Harbor Freight rail and style bit and a panel bit. So today we are going to go ahead and stain the edges, and we're going to get them fit in a frame, and then we're going to start assembling this nightstand. So here we go on that. I'm going to be using the same stain as the bed. Sorry. That's the Minwax Dark Walnut. It made the bed look real good. And obviously, we want the nightstand to match the bed. And we'll be using the same stain on the dresser when we do it. So stay tuned for that. I'm going to go ahead and stain these and get them in there, and then we'll come back and get them all assembled up. I got the edges all done up. I got my rails all cut. If y'all want to see some footage of me cutting these, I'll put it up down here somewhere. And you can check it out while I put these together. So when you put these together, you only put glue here. You don't put any glue down inside these channels because you want room for these to expand and contract. In my house, the reason I do this is because it's really dry in my house and these are going to shrink up. So I pre-finished them. We're not going to put any glue in here. We're just going to put it on the ends and clamp them together. So I'm going to do that now. You guys can do that and check out some of this video down here. And then we'll start pocket holding.
I really do like this method of putting furniture together. It gives you a nice result and it's pretty stable too. I've not had anything really fall apart using this method so far, but you know, I've only built a couple of things with it, but it does look good. Definitely looks good. Plus everything usually comes out pretty square. So after getting everything assembled and the glue is all dried, I go ahead and I just hit the corners with a sander just to knock down any of the squeeze out. Everything seems to be pretty flush and pretty good. Just needs a little bit at 120 grit. Now to hold these four panels together, I'll be using 1¼ pocket holes. So I got a pocket hole. Using my door, I set up for my face frame. That way I can get my drawer space in, and these are pocket holed in as well. With my face frame all done, we can go ahead and put some glue on both sides. Yeah, both sides, dummy. Because I won't be able to get any glue on it after I get one side pocket holed in. So I get everything squared up and screwed in, and everything's holding good and tight. And then I square up the other side, and we'll go ahead and stain the inside of this now. That way I don't have to stand on my head to get everything stained later on. It's easier to do it this way, so this is how I've done it. Once we get the inside of it all stained up, I'm going to go ahead and stain the outside of it too. This is going to have to dry for a couple of weeks before I take it in the house. The smell of the stain kind of gets to you after a while. So now we got that all done, looking pretty. I'm gonna go ahead and we'll get started on the drawers and the top and the bottom.
So I got my drawer built. Nothing fancy. I didn't show y'all a whole lot of that. Maybe I'll do a drawer build someday. Just pocket holes and glue, bottom. But what I did wanna show y'all was this next part. We gotta pick out what we want the front to be. So that one, I think I like this side better. There's not a whole lot on it. So we're gonna go with this side as the front. Now we're gonna put a round over around the rest of it. We don't wanna put it on the front at all. And that'll make sense later on. I'll show you. Here we go.
So I've set my fence on both sides just to the edge of the bit. And what I'm doing is I'm plunging in right behind the face panel of the drawer. I want all the edges on that face panel nice and crisp. That way when we put the trim on, everything is nice, sharp, and crisp, and the rest of the drawer has a nice, comfortable round over all the way around. Next, I'm going to round over the inside edges as well. I just like the way it looks. I don't think we really needed it, but again, I just like the way it looks. So I cut some 1-inch strips. I put a 1/4-inch OG on it, and we went ahead and mitered the corners. This will serve as the trim plate for our drawer. Now, in hindsight, I kind of wish I would have went with cedar trim on this, and you'll see why later on in the video. But, I mean, the pine turned out pretty good, and I didn't have a whole lot of cedar to do them all anyway. See what I was talking about those nice crisp edges? Nice and clean. So when this thing sits back in the drawer box, it'll be beautiful. Now I gotta figure out what I'm gonna do for my top. I've glued this big panel together and I can get a top and bottom out of this one panel, which still leaves me with an extra glued up panel, which is pretty nice. I'll have to find a project for that. What I'm gonna do is I set the nightstand carcass on top of what will be the bottom. And then I'm gonna pre-drill my holes. That way I can just screw this right to the bottom and I don't have to do anything fancy. I just set the carcass on there, drew a line all the way around, removed the carcass, and put screws right down the middle. Nothing super special about this. I just went and ran some 2-inch screws and that was all done. Now for the top, I had some of these left over. So I'm gonna go ahead and use those for this project and I will order Z-clips for the long dresser. And we'll try them, see how those work out. These have worked good on all my other projects. And like I said, I had them left over. So why would I spend more money on something I really haven't spent a whole lot of money on thus far? Ah, a little bit of foreshadowing there earlier. Yeah, that cedar trim I was talking about. Yeah, well, this is it. It's pretty. I love the way it looks. I don't like working with it though. It's too brittle in my opinion. The reason I went with cedar is because I needed something that was around 2 inches for the top and the bottom for the drawer pulls to fit in. Now, I guess I could have went with white oak because I had plenty of that on hand. But again, I didn't pay anything for this cedar. It was left over from another project. So that's what I used. Now here you see me putting a back stopper on the drawer. This is so the drawer doesn't fly out when you pull on it. Looky there. See how nice and tight that fits? So the picture shows a type of barn door hinge, as you can see here. Now, I did have to go down to Lowe's and buy some of them because the ones I had on hand were much too large. But the cost wasn't too bad, so I'm all right with it. I'm using that Kreg jig to set up my door pull, and then we'll install the door. Now it's time to lay out for those drawer pulls. Now the drawer pulls are going to be the same as what was on the bed. And I used the exact same drill bit with that same piece of tape on there to use as a flag. Now we are going to put on some leveling feet because I think I've mentioned before that my floors in my house are not level. So leveling feet are a plus in my home. I did a quick sand with some 80 grit paper. I didn't want to go too high on the grit because I still wanted a rough look. And I achieved that because I went ahead and stained it off camera and it looked pretty good. Put the first coat of armor seal on real heavy. Then I'll come back, hit it with some 120 grit, another coat of armor seal, some 220 grit, another coat of armor seal, and then we'll wipe on the armor seal after 320 grit. I just put a little bit of paste wax on the inside of the drawer because I've noticed on some antique furniture, they didn't seem to finish the insides of their drawers. So this will be the last sanding I do on the top. This is that 320 grit, and what I'm going to try to do is distress it a little bit. And then we'll go back and put that armor seal on. We'll just go ahead and wipe it on with a rag. This is a pretty heavy coat of armor seal as it is right now, and it's really starting to look good. I don't know if y'all are a big fan of multicolored projects, but the way this oak and this cedar and this pine all come together, I am just thrilled with the way these colors are turning out together. So off camera, I went ahead and mixed up a little shot glass full of epoxy. Now, I'm not going to drink it because it probably turned out bad, but I am going to use it in this video. We're going to put that epoxy on these drawer pulls just like we did on the bed. And then we're going to hammer the crap out of them to get them to seat. Hopefully that epoxy will hold them in there permanently and forever. I mean, the way the hole's drilled, and as much as I had to hammer on it, the epoxy may not even have been needed. But I figure more is better than less, so I went ahead with more this time.
Well, it's all done. What do y'all think of the cedar stained with that dark walnut? I like it. Gives it a different look. I like the natural stain too, but I think this kind of contrasts the pine. Looks pretty good. Got our studs in there, our drawer pulls. Got 19 of them on there, so that's about $40. The handle I already had from another project, so that didn't cost me anything. I had to get the hinges. So this project has cost me about $70 in total. All the wood was free. Not only was it free, it was scrap. I had it over in my scrap pile in the corner and didn't have any projects slated for it because it didn't look that great. I mean, we started out with a bunch of boards that looked like this, and all the staples leave a lot of holes, and they just don't look good on larger projects. Plus, we had a bunch of them that had this big chunk out of it, and they were only about 36 inches long. So this was a good project to use these boards on. The tabletops, again, I didn't have to do any extra work for those. I already had them left over from another project. I mean, this scrap wood project here. And for a scrap wood project, I think it turned out pretty good. I didn't have to get into none of my good pallet wood up there. Drawer opens nice, closes nice. That was the door. Let's try the drawer now. The drawer works good, pulls out nice. Slides right out. Just got that center rail. Got a nice snug fit. So, y'all got any extra wood laying around? Build your nightstand. It's not really that hard. And it looks good too. So, I'm gonna give y'all a walk around as we get out of here. And hit that like button, subscribe, and share it with all your friends. Maybe they might want one. See y'all later.